For centuries, we've been warned of the dangers that lurk deep beneath the ocean's surface. Maybe there's a horrifying colossal squid, or a kraken, or an evil villain's lair. But as it turns out, the reality is far worse. Hey there, pollutant population. Jules here for dnews. The Mariana Trench is the deepest known part of the ocean, stretching down roughly 36,000 feet. You'd imagine that at those depths, the ocean floor is pristine, almost untouched by human activity. Well, I've got some bad news for you. Turns out, the bottom of the ocean is very, very polluted. And that's not some clickbait hyperbole. It's more polluted than some of the most polluted regions on the surface of the globe. One probe into the Marianas Trench only had to go about 16,000 feet down to find physical remnants of actual garbage, not just waste byproducts. Beer cans, plastic bags, even an entire can of Spam was found resting along the trench's wall. And unless it's removed, this trash can stay down there indefinitely, just piling up. Plastics, for example, are made up of super strong carbon-to-carbon bonds. These bonds are not prone to being broken down by organic organisms. The material hasn't existed in nature long enough for there to have evolved much to break it down. In 2016, scientists did find one type of microbe that can do it, but only for a specific type of plastic. And even if we could solve this physical trash problem, there lies an even deeper problem. Literally. In late 2016, a paper published in the journal Nature examined the inhabitants of two of the deepest oceanic trenches in the world. Small little crustaceans, called amphipods, are the perfect study specimen because they have fatty tissues, which stores not just fat, but also any chemicals that are ingested. And despite these amphipods being located in two different parts of the world, thousands of feet below the surface, they were all contaminated by what are called persistent organic pollutants, or POPs. Persistent meaning that they don't break down in their environment and are almost impossible to remove. These include chemicals that have been banned from use for decades, at least in the United States, like polychlorinated biphenyls, which have been shown to cause birth defects and cancer. Other chemicals, like pesticides, were also present. The concentration of POPs was so high that it was 50 times greater than in one of China's most polluted rivers, and it was roughly equal to that of Suruga Bay in Japan, which is an industrial waste dumping ground. So, how did this pollution make it all the way down there? Well, the researchers suggest that, in the case of the Mariana Trench, it may have a little to do with something called the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. While there are many areas where trash congregates in the ocean, the paper refers to a huge floating clump of garbage in the Northwest Pacific Ocean that floats just near the Marianas Trench. So plastics and other chemicals end up sinking to its depths. There's another theory that this pollution is the result of POP chemicals entering the food chain. The amphipods that live in these deep waters are scavengers. And when a larger animal, like a dolphin or a whale, dies, it slowly sinks to the bottom of the ocean floor, which is a phenomenon known as carrion falls. If this carrion lived in polluted waters, then it could have pollution in its system, and that pollution would persist in the animals that eat it. The paper does say that this is unlikely, given that there's consistent contamination at different depths. But either of these theories for how the POPs got so deep are a huge problem for humans. If these chemicals are so persistent within the food chain, then they eventually reach our own food supply, contaminating it with our own contaminants. But it isn't just bad for us, it's bad for every living thing. Ocean pollution saps the amount of oxygen in the water, which can lead to mass death of marine life. Certain chemicals can even create reproductive issues for animals in the ocean. So even if they do survive, they can't do much for their species. Society has spent the last few centuries dumping tons of trash into the ocean, including industrial waste, radioactive waste, munitions, even sewage. The EPA says, quote, "Wastes were frequently dumped into coastal and ocean waters based on the assumption that marine waters had an unlimited capacity to mix and disperse wastes." But now we're learning that this isn't really the case. This out of sight, out of mind approach is killing ocean creatures and endangering our own health. It turns out, nowhere is safe from pollution, not even the deepest part of the ocean. We can't do dnews episodes without our sponsors. Thanks to Gray's for sponsoring this episode. Gray's makes snacking exciting by combining wholesome ingredients with flavors we all love to create over 100 nutritionist-approved snacks. Go to Gray's.com and enter promo code dnews to get a free sampler box delivered to your home or work. So what actually lives down in the deepest places on Earth? Well, we have a video all about that right here. And do you have any other questions about oceans or pollution or just science? Let us know down below in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more dnews every day.